All right, folks, God bless you. Here we go. I rang a bell out there on a little church the other day. The ministry the Lord gave me, I don't even know how many years ago he told me to name it Before the Fire. It's my testimony, and I've given my testimony many, many times, that the night I got saved, I knew there was a fire coming to destroy everything. Just like Noah knew and was warned of God that water was coming to destroy everything, I was warned of God that fire was coming to destroy everything. I've told y'all since the night I got saved, I knew it. And so, over all the years, the Lord has poured through me all this just critical information to understanding the Bible. He gave me the unrolled scroll. He literally unrolled the scroll, the Bible, unrolled it, and allowed me to understand it and to present it to whoever would be seeking the truth. Jesus is the truth. So now, I'm going to give you a testimony that the end is coming imminently. It is absolutely imminent. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the way the Lord communicated that message to me and how he communicated it not once, not twice, not three times, but over and over and over and over again. So I would know with confidence that I could proclaim the coming of the Lord is at hand. The coming of the King is at the door. I mean, this is beyond my comprehension almost. I've always known who I was since I got saved. I knew I was someone very special to God because of the way I got saved. But now I know for sure that the fire is going to be here. It's coming imminently. And we're supposed to be on the ready, starting right this second, right now. So it could happen any moment. So that's what I'm going to convey to you tonight. I'm going to show you how he conveyed it to me. I'm going to go through the sequence. I'll probably call Corey. I may call Kat, just to get witnesses as a testimony so you can hear other people's voices. Because, guys, we've been freaking out. I mean, imagine. You know, I can't imagine when the Lord told Noah, hey, you know that ark you've been working on? Go ahead and go on in and close the door. Well, last Monday, the Lord told me to ring the bell, and I rang the bell. Now, I don't know what the time frame is. I mean, it could be tonight, but I can guarantee you this. When you watch this information that I'm going to give you, and you see how it's been delivered, there's only one thing I can surmise. It is inevitable, imminent, very quickly, very quickly. The whole world shut down. Have y'all noticed? You know why, right? What's this all been about? A whole new species. Just like Lady Gaga said, my performance at the Grammy Awards is about a new race of beings being birthed within the human race. So they're getting rid of the old man and bringing in the new man, and theirs is a two-down system. This is what it was. We've been walking around double downs that are taking this, the right side up, upside down paradigm, to the pit. And when we get converted in their system, we turn two ups. That goes home. This is in the system. This is one of them. That's the system. So pay attention. If you don't understand all what I'm talking about, if you're new here, go watch the video I did called You Are Exiles. Go watch The Queen of Heaven and start there, I guess. But for those of y'all that have been here, I have something very amazing for y'all. I believe our time is any moment, literally any moment. Okay, so without any further ado, here we go. Let me just familiarize you with some stuff you may or may not know. So there's a movie called Knowing. I'm going to play the trailer for Knowing. I don't even know when it came out. 2009 in 2009. Okay, now the same guy that did the Knowing movie did I, Robot. Why is that important? Well, I'm going to show you real quick why it's important. Because in the movie I, Robot, where a bunch of robots take over, he telegraphed. Will Smith woke up in the morning and the radio came on and it was 9/11. See right there, it showed you 9 and then it showed the 11. And during that, During this movie, I should say, we got to look at Detective Spooner's badge, and his badge number was 4084. 4084 in the Bible, when, I've learned the way they communicate. I know the way they communicate. The Lord's made me fluent in their language. 4084 is piazo. It means to lay hold of, to take. I lay hold of, apprehend, catch, and arrest. There. So it's from the scriptures where they came to seize Jesus. They wanted to seize him. They came that they might seize him, to arrest him, to catch, seize, and arrest. So the number 4084 in the Bible, which just happens to be Detective Spooner, who is a detective, and what's his job? To catch, apprehend, and arrest. Well, that's quite a convenient number for your badge number, don't you think? 4084? What, did you look it up in the Bible and come up with it? Obviously you did. Obviously whatever's running that person that's the director is using that alphanumeric system straight out of the Bible. Let me prove that to you one more time. So let's say by some mind-destroying coincidence, a detective in the movie, which is Will Smith, has a badge number that's 4084, and 4084 in the Bible just happens to mean I apprehend, lay hold of, catch, and arrest. Just by some bizarre circumstance. Let's just say that's a possibility. Well, they show us in the movie that he gets a new pair of Converse, and when he opens them up, there's an upside down star right in front of where his genitalia would be. But this is what's most important. Chicago 2035. And they're making an allusion to that sigil of Baphomet right in front of his reproductive organs. So Chicago 2035 is when iRobot takes place. And they put this on the screen to let you know, hey, it takes place in Chicago in 2035. Well, wouldn't it just be crazy if we looked up 2035 in the Bible and all of a sudden it was completely significant? That would indicate that it's planned, it's done with intent. Something's doing it with intent. Something would have to know, and it's not a coincidence. So let's go ahead and do that. Chicago 2035. Let's look that up in the Bible. So what's the number 2035 in the Bible? An overthrow, destruction, insurrection. There it is. An overthrow, 2035. Overthrow, destruction, insurrection. Now, what is the movie iRobot all about? It's about a bunch of robots taking over, an overthrow. So now we've clearly lined it out. The song Very Superstitious comes on, and it's the devil's on his way. It says, very superstitious, the devil's on his way. It shows 9/11. Where's the devil? The bottomless pit. The devil's on his way. Then it just happens to be that his badge number is 4084. I catch, apprehend, and arrest. Very convenient for a detective badge number. Then Chicago 2035, insurrection, takeover. Well, that's very convenient because the whole movie's about an insurrection and takeover. So now if you think that's some bizarre coincidence, you're just not functioning in a mental capacity that should probably be watching this video. Anyway, so it's obvious, very obvious. So I made the point there. Now, I'm going to make the point now again. I'm going to show you the trailer for the movie Knowing. So I'm going to show you the trailer. I want you to watch the trailer. If you've seen the movie, even better. But I'm Jonathan Kleck. Yahweh has given a bell ringer, someone that rings the bell and gathers the church. That's what my name means. When you translate, Jonathan means Yahweh has given. Kleck means a messenger that rings the bell by a church and gathers the church. So I'm just saying that's what my name translates as. So, it's just what it is. I didn't know that till after I got saved and the Lord showed me, this is your identity in Christ. So that's my identity in Christ. Yahweh's given a bell ringer, a town crier. And I rang a bell on Monday, and everything about it was supernatural. Even the very moment I rang the bell meant, shall be a sign unto thee, bing, 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 bing. And it meant to truth, to speak only truth. That's what it, 2:26. The Lord told me, look at the very moment you rang the bell. By the way, that day, my phone was beeping. It was really annoying. Hey, when are you going to ring the bell? When are you going to ring the bell? It's like, really? I was like, dude, when the Lord tells me to ring the bell. I thought I was going to do it in the morning, but He made sure I rang it at 2:26 because the Lord's perfection, he knows how to communicate to his servants so they understand what's going on. And that's what you're about to see. You're about to see the Lord's communication to his servant, through his servant to you. So you know what's going on. That's it. It's that simple. Ready? Here we go. Let's watch this.
You and me together forever. The theory of randomness says it's all simply coincidence. There is no grand meaning, making it possible for you to be sitting here in this riveting lecture.
50 years ago, the students of William Dawes Elementary imagined what the future might hold. Today, we unveiled their legacy.
Okay, why are you showing me this?
It's a list of dates.
Every major global disaster for the last 50 years in perfect sequence. From a piece of paper that's been buried in the ground for 5 decades.
The next number on the chain predicts that tomorrow, 81 people are going to die in some kind of tragedy.
Get off the train.
Why? What's wrong?
I'll just take the baby and get off the train.
Estimates put the presumed dead at 81.
The prediction came true. It's not coincidence. Don't let him watch the news.
Why won't you tell me what's going on? They were here.
Who?
The Whisperer people.
What do you want with my son?
The numbers are a warning. They're a warning to everyone.
This is not a test. This is an emergency broadcast transmission.
We're going to stay on the air for as long as possible.
Are we going to die?
I will never let that happen, Caleb. Do you hear me? Never.
Okay, so, very interesting movie. If you've seen the movie, it's really quite fascinating. I'm going to be pulling that trailer up again and show you some stuff from it during the course of this presentation. It's really important that you see the stuff from this movie and understand that the same director that did iRobot did this movie. So that would suggest maybe the same director that did iRobot and did 4084, Catch, Apprehend, and Arrest for Detective Spooner's Badge, and 2035 for Chicago for an insurrection and takeover, where a bunch of robots insurrect and take over. Wonder if he did the same thing in the movie Knowing. I wonder if the Lord God could use the fact that I know how to read their language to use that as a way to communicate to me before the fire, that the fire was coming and it's imminent, and that the locusts that I've been telling you are coming are also imminent. That's what we're going to do. Let's go ahead and do that. So now, in order to make you fully understand just how poignant and how powerful this communication was, it's very important that you understand simply the things I understand and how simple they really are. Everything is based on a set of twins, 9 and then 1 and 1. 1 and 1, look at those as twins. 1 is a one, one is a twin of 1. That's why in this system we have people like Debbie Harry with the twin cake of herself cutting out her own heart. That's why the Bible says, when, you know, let me read the Targum to you first, and without going over the whole thing in the Bible, which I've done many times. I've broken down Genesis 4 and shown you that, and she, Eve continued to bear. She augmented her birth. The word is augment. She added to bear, and the word is augmented her birth with Abel from Cain. Here is the Targum. And Adam knew Hava, Eve's wife, who had desired the angel. And she conceived and bare Cain. And she said, I have acquired a man, the angel of the Lord. And she added to bear from her husband Adam his twin, even Habel. So that's from the Targum Jonathan. And you can go look it up yourself. I'm not going through the whole thing. I've done this too many times. I've gone straight to the Bible and proved, using the language of the Bible, Cain and Abel were twins. So let me give you an example of, I'm going to put a V on one of their heads and a V on the other one, just like, because it's a cannibalistic system, this represents you. There's a good you and there's a bad you, and the cannibalistic Cain you is killing the Abel you. So you are your own murderer. You murder yourself because there's an angel and a demon inside of you. There's one right side up you, and there's an upside down you, just like a set of twins. There's one that's upside down. There's one that's right side up. There's a double U, and here's the letter W to represent it. Now, in this system, this represents an angel right over here, a star. The head, the arm, the leg. This represents one of God's angels. But when they get caught in this system, they get turned upside down, and you take an angel and you turn it upside down, and that becomes the sigil of Baphomet, which is the church of Satan, because the host body system becomes the habitation of Satan. Here's a Roman numeral 5. Here's a Roman numeral 5. It's also the letter V. So when you put that together, it makes a W. And this is symbology they love to use, so that's why I'm showing it to you. Now also, just so everybody knows, something that's very simple that everyone should know is, it's an alphanumeric system, and I've shown you. One A, B, C. The letter C is the number 3 in their alphanumeric system. And the number 3 in the Bible is the angel of the bottomless pit. I know a whole lot of this stuff already by memory because I use it so much. Okay, but also A, B, C, D, E. So, you know, V. Okay, what's another way of saying like A, B, C, D, E, the number 5? You can delineate the number 5 by simply using the letter E, because E is a fifth letter of the alphabet. So I put E and E, that's 5 and 5. Just remember that, because I see things the way they do things. I'm as wise as a serpent. I know what they're doing. Isn't it odd? I wore camouflage on for a reason today. Isn't it interesting that we're in a system where they're so completely camouflaged? They're the eyes and the ears of the bottomless pit, and they're hunting us. Wouldn't it be ironic if we're the ones that are in full camouflage and they're hunting us, but the trap they set has become their own? I can assure you that's the truth. That's why I'm wearing this. Okay, now let me do that one more time. A, B, C, D, E. So E is the fifth letter of the alphabet. So if you have E and E, you have a 5 and a 5. Okay, if you have a C and a C, you have a 3 and a 3. I just want to make sure in your mind you have a working knowledge right now of that. Okay, now I'm going to give you a testimony. I think I'll call Corey up and put Corey on speakerphone and just let y'all hear another voice. I want you to hear someone else's voice that was part of this as it began, but this testimony spans a day and a half. It started last night, and it's been going all day. And I've just been like, it's been so off the charts, it's almost not processable. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to call Corey right now and just let y'all hear from him for a sec and then continue. Turn your volume all the way up. Okay, so guys, I have Corey on speakerphone here. And anyway, so I'm just giving you guys an extra witness. So Corey, just say, hey, everybody.
Hey, guys.
There he is. Yeah, the church. That's right.
The
church that's being called out. If you guys are able to receive all this, it's y'all are gonna freak out. Here.
Absolutely.
Mind blowing. So anyway, so last night I was going to get my son some of this Mexican candy called leche quemada that he just really loves, and I was just trying to be nice and go do something for him. And on the way there, I was talking to you, right, Corey? And what, do you remember, like, a part of the topic of our conversation was?
We were talking about the double V and the whole system
Yep. And so, so anyway, I was driving to this Mexican restaurant called Martha's, and I was talking about their symbology is so obvious. They use this VV, the number five, all the time. And, you know, and E is also the number five. And I've seen them do it just so pervasively. It's so easy to knock off now. And that, does that sound kind of like the conversation we were having? And then right then I'm like, oh, wow, check it out. And I looked over and what did I see?
You saw the coffee shop with the brevity.
Right.
And the V was going splitting right between the two E's. Perfect.
Right. So I'm gonna show everybody. I said, I'm going to take a picture while we were on the phone, right?
Yeah.
Yep. So I'm going to show everybody the picture I took from my phone at night. I went back over there today and I got a better picture of it because – you know, it was kind of washed out on the phone because I was a long way away. But so I have up on the screen, it says brevity, and the V is real big, and the V is going right between the E and the E of the word coffee. Does that sound right? And so that was right during the middle of our conversation about the number five and the Roman numeral five V and how they love using the V, and That's their whole thing, and they mock the crap out of us all the time doing it. Yeah.
Yeah, always.
And then I went, oh wow, check it out. There it is, right there on a coffee company. And I'm like, oh wow. And I was like, the V is going right between two E's, which is five and five. There it is again. And that was kind of where we were freaking out, right?
Absolutely. Like, I was sitting there listening and orchestrating the whole conversation, man.
Absolutely. So then, after that, I mean, you've talked to me probably how many times since then?
It's nonstop. It's like, I don't know, four or five times a day, and the stuff that the Lord is showing you, dude, is just pouring through like a waterfall. It's like nonstop. You can't make any of this stuff up. It's crazy.
Yeah, you couldn't even think this stuff up. And then the Lord's also, by a bizarre set of circumstances, there has been several times in the past day that I've actually been talking to you and the words coming out of my mouth, while they're coming out of my mouth, I'm like, oh my gosh, right then something happens that very moment, right?
Yep.
Okay, and then one of those things is also involves you. What was the movie you watched today that had the... Yeah, Urban Justice.
There you go.
Yeah, well, hang on, because I'm trying to stay on track. I don't want to go off on an Urban Justice thing right now, because I got to do everything in order, and we're not even close to Urban Justice yet. But you did watch a movie called Urban Justice, and a very bizarre thing happened in it, correct?
Absolutely, for sure.
That would suggest Locust and the Angel of the Bottomless Pit and Scorpions all at once, correct?
Yep.
And did we document it?
We did. We always do.
We always do. All right. Well, I'll tell you what. So I'm going to just freak out right now and just get into the testimony. And then if I need to call you back, I'll call, you know, within the next 30 minutes probably.
No worries. I'll be ready.
All right. Cool. Bye. All right. So Corey and Kat have been watching what's going on. They've been privy to it. So there you go. So this is where it all started. Now, I mean, you know, I can understand where a lot of people might be going, yeah, so what? Well, when you understand that their system is, and the entire system is, even the reconciliation of the system is Christ in between the two, the five and the five, half and half, and Jesus reconciling one to the and the other back to God through the cross. When you really understand the system, and you even understand that even their symbology in the Catholic Church, which means completely down, is a double-headed phoenix here with, this is a DNA ribbon, which is a V and a V, making a W with a serpent head ruling over it. When you understand how important this symbology is, and you see what's about to be delivered to you right now with the understanding, what you're going to see today is impossible. Okay, but yet you're going to see it. Okay, so here we go. Let's go back to here. That's the trailer. I'm going to go back to the beginning. I'm going to leave. Let's see. Strong's. Okay, so let's get to folder 5. For those of y'all that have folder 5, I highly suggest you grab it and go through it with me. There's so much information in this thing. And at the same time, at the end of this thing, at the end of this presentation of the Lord confirming that the end is immediately coming right now. It's coming. Okay, so when I say right now, I know how a lot of people go, the end is imminent and we are staring it in the face right now. I'll let you decide from what I deliver. So I'm going to show you the Google Doodle and I'm going to show you a scene from Predator. You already saw Saint Corona, but get ready for this. Here we go. Okay, so right after I saw Brevity, last night. So here's the order of events. I saw Brevity Coffee and I was talking to Corey and I went, wow, look how they even take the V and they put it right between the two E's. Because when you do that and you put the V, but that their V between the two E's, their symbology is right in front of your face. E is the number 5 and E is the number 5 again. And they're saying they've taken the system like V for victory. And this is represents their winning between the 5 and 5. They've taken over. That's what it represents. So there's a nice big clean image of it. Not at night, not lit up, but a nice easy image for you to look at. Okay, let me get this one right down at the bottom again. I'm sorry that I have to scroll like this, but this folder is huge. This is just one folder, folks, and it is stacked. So here's the order of events. I was driving to go get Leche Kamada. I looked over. We were having a talk. I was having a talk with Corey about how they love their twin system, how they love the letter V and the number 5. And this is even one of my folders, how I've delineated just how much they love it, how much they use it. They use it on stuff like the Prisoner Wine Company. It's a V intersecting a V. They use it on Twin Liquors. It is so pervasive. They use it even for the city of Waco, Texas. That's a V and a V, one with the star, one with the crescent moon. And when you turn it upside down, the two Vs become 9/11, Angel of the Bottomless Pit. So now we have this pattern that's emerged in this pattern that's turned out to be very obvious. Twin Liquors, C twin, V and V. Well, again, you can also get the number 5 from the letter E. So when I came home last night to bring home this Leche Kamada to my son, and I came home and there was a movie on that was called Knowing, and I just showed you the trailer. Well, I was working on the computer and I looked up at the TV and it was Knowing. I just heard in my spirit, leave it on, watch it. I've seen it before. You know, I didn't particularly go, oh, I'm going to see something. Not at all. I wasn't like all freaking out on Knowing. But I did notice it was on and I looked up. And in Knowing, there is a scene where I had come in at the part where this plane is crashing and Nicolas Cage is like freaking out because he's got this paper that was dug up from this time capsule and it's been in the ground for 50 years, 5 decades. 5, and then they use the word decade because 5 and 5 is their system. Get it? 5. A decade is 10. He goes, it's been in the ground for 5 decades. So they're using it. So I noticed the symbology right away. And so he's holding the sheet of paper and the sheet of paper shows every catastrophic event that's occurred over 50 years and the location and the number of people dead. And he's the guy that's like figured it out and he's freaking out. Well, I'm the guy that the Lord has let figured out the way they communicate. So what you're about to see is so supernatural and so mind-blowing that the Lord is using it against them to communicate to his messenger that the end is coming, because the movie The Knowing is about the end and the fire that's coming to destroy the earth. Okay, so here it is. I took a picture from the scene where the fire is coming. I had Dave right before the fire because that's been my ministry since the Lord named it. And the very night he named it, the first radio call I had, someone came in and confess Christ as their Savior, and their name meant Child of Fire, Yvonne Hughes. And so, here we go. So then I start watching this movie, And he's looking at all these numbers and he's trying to figure out what's going on and why this is happening. And at the end of the list is here's the end of the list. So there's these numbers right here, and he's wondering, why did they turn the two threes backwards? And so he's trying to desperately find out, because the other events have all occurred except the last event. And so now I'm like going, wow, this is interesting. And he's trying to find out where, why, and what the deal is with this last event. So he contacts his girl, whose mother had written the list and put it in there, because he wants to get some inside information into what's going on. And so he ends up out at this place, like in the country, where Lucinda's mom had a little cabin. And she says to him, I don't think it's a number. I think it's letters like E and E. And now all of a sudden I just went, wait a minute. E and E, 5 and 5. And he looks down on the ground and there's a little black stone at the edge of the bed. And he flips the bed upside down. Let me show you that. That's in the show notes. And he flips the bed upside down. And here's what's written under the bed, underneath the entire bed that's been turned upside down. So there it is. Everyone else, E-E, everyone else, everyone else, every E-E, everyone else, everyone else. So what she's saying is, the last event, everyone else is going to die, because in every other event, there's a number of the people that'll die, and everyone's been correct so far. And so he's like, oh my Lord, everyone else is about to die. Oh, I'm the end of the world guy. I'm like Noah. I'm the before the fire guy. Now all of a sudden I'm like, oh wow, E is the number 5, and E is the number 5. So, and then I went, oh my Lord, I just saw Brevity Coffee coming home, and there's a big V going between the two E's, which is a 5. Oh, in the movie, it's EE, right? Weird. And now I'm looking at the screen going, wait a minute. And then I feel just the presence of the Lord telling me to watch, and I'm like, weird. And so it's everyone else. Well, now he's like really freaked out, because he's trying to get the kids to safety. He wants to know, what can I possibly do to save these kids? Because he goes to his lab and he realizes there's going to be this corona blast and it's just going to wipe out and burn the whole planet. Oh, that's sounding pretty biblical, actually. And so I'm sitting there watching and I'm just going like, oh my Lord. And then the Lord's just telling me to pay attention, pay attention. Well, at one point he freaks out and he goes and he grabs his door, a door. That's interesting. I just painted that door red, you know, the doorpost and the lintel. And the painting, the color on the door had a number. It was 140. I'll have to look up what that means again. I've had so many things happen. So, I mean, you know what? I want to see what 140 means again, because, I mean, it's just so unbelievable, all the things that have happened here. 140, my Lord has arisen, right? So I painted a door right there with the king's crown, and it in the color of the paint number that's 140 says no more drama. It says my Lord has arisen. Okay, back down to what I was doing. Now, all of a sudden, I'm sitting here going, this is crazy. I just saw a V that was cutting between two E's. Now, all of a sudden, I'm looking at a movie called Knowing, where fire burns everything. And then the E and the E is where the whole everyone else is going to die. 5 and 5. I'm like, that is crazy. And then all of a sudden, Nicolas Cage is taking the paint off an old door, and he finds a latitude and longitude, 42, 75, and 71, 37. And I was like, okay. And I heard the Lord say, look it up. 74, 42, 75. Just read it for yourself. So, again, in the movie, where the event's supposed to take place, right here. See the five-pointed star? A five-pointed star, like one of God's angels. I showed that to you over here in the twin system. That's a representation of an angel right there. See the five-pointed star? You turn it upside down, it becomes the Church of Satan. Five-pointed star up is one of God's children. So 4275 right here by 7137. So that's where the event is going to take place, because in the movie, every longitude and latitude is in the number sequence, and then the number of dead. Well, the last number sequence is 4275. And this other number I'll show you in a minute. And everyone else is going to die. Imagine if you were me. Well, I've already known this since 2002. I'll look you in the eye. I've known since 2002 everyone's about to die. I've been carrying that burden this long. Now, let's look that up real quick. It means to foresee. I see beforehand. Oh, wow, that's pretty prolific, because the whole movie's about seeing everything before it happens. Let me read 4275. It means pro. The word is proedo, proedo. It means pro, before, and edo, to see. Properly, to foresee, to know in advance. That's pretty wild, because the movie is called Knowing. Used of God foreseeing, planning out all of history from eternity past. This guarantees all physical scenes of life operate according to, under his plan, and bringing equal eternal benefit to the person walking in faith. Divine persuasion in each of them. Accordingly, 4275, proelon and faith are directly connected. So there you go. Therefore, be sure that it is those who are of faith, who are sons of Abraham. The scripture foreseen, and the word is 4275, that God would justify the Gentiles by faith, 4102, pistis, preached the gospel beforehand to Abraham, saying, all nations will be blessed in you. So then those who are of faith are blessed with Abraham, the believer. Now watch. This is fascinating. It's to foresee and to see beforehand. Also, now I'm going to pop open the show notes real quick. 4275, to see beforehand. Now, if you haven't seen the movie, you find out during the movie, at the end of the movie, spoiler alert, well, the dad ends up getting there, and the kids are there, and the kids are about to be taken out, and there's angels that are there to take them and get them out of there, because the whole world's about to burn. And this is sounding a lot like a ministry of a guy I know. Before the fire. You will name your ministry Before the Fire. Because there's a fire coming to destroy everybody. I've been telling everybody that for a long time. And the Lord God gave me all the proof. But now he's really got my attention. And I'm looking at a movie where children are getting to safety. Well, that's weird. The Lord promised me the night he saved me, I'll get four to safety for what you do for me. Kind of like the way he promised Noah. What you do for me, I'll get your children to safety. He promised me the same thing. Well, so when I'm looking at this number, 4275, and I'm like, the latitude is 4275. Are you joking me? It's 4275, and it means to see in advance. Okay, let's watch that trailer one more time. And during the trailer, I'm going to stop and show you some stuff. Okay, so let's do that.
You and me together forever.
Did y'all catch that? What did he do? They both made triangles with their thumbs. Oh, wow. Escape artist Wow, look at that. Escape artist. Wow, look at the guy running through the eye. Did you know I have something very much like that in one of my containers, the one that's the Bride of Christ in Grand Junction?
The theory of randomness says it's all simply coincidence. There is no grand meaning, making it possible for you to be sitting here in this riveting lecture.
50 years ago, the students of William...
Okay, right there, they pulled off a lid. Do you know it says 2009 and has another number here? And I have them both written down. Did you know both these numbers are so significant you're going to freak out? I'll show them to you in just a minute. They're in the show notes.
Students of William Dawes Elementary imagined what the future might hold. Today, we unveiled their legacy.
There is a pattern to predicting the future. Let's go ahead and slow this down a little bit.
Okay.
Let me go back and do this. Okay, let me slow this down. Just my back speed. Did you see it? They only did it for just a moment. There is a pattern to predicting the future. It goes backwards. Watch. I'm trying to catch it, so let me just... Did you see it? There it is. There is a pattern to predicting the future. Did you see it? There it is on your screen. You're looking right at that. 100% nylon. Turn it upside down. Wow. Upside down and backwards. Look at that. How about that? So now that you saw that, let me go to normal speed. Here we go.
Okay, why are you showing me this?
It's a list of dates. Every major global disaster for the last 50 years in perfect sequence. A piece of paper that's been buried in the ground for 5 decades.
5 decades. Okay, it said there is an order to our deepest fears. Did you see it? It did it again. I'm not going to slow it down. You can do it on your own time. It does the same thing. It goes backwards. Backwards and upside down. So there you go.
Next number on the chain predicts that tomorrow, 81 people...
predicts that 81 people
die in some kind of tragedy.
Get off the train. Why?
What's wrong?
Just take the baby and get off the train.
So I'm going to pause it for a sec. So what's this whole movie about? This guy has solved something and he knows what's coming. Oh, you mean like 2035, Chicago 2035? Insurrection takeover? iRobot? Oh, you mean like Detective Spooner's badge? 4084, I apprehend, catch, and arrest. So what's running this guy and what's having him put this alphanumeric system in his movies is giving away the enemy's plans.
Estimates put the presumed dead at 81. The
prediction came true. It's not coincidence.
Did y'all hear that noise?
Don't let him watch them. Prediction came true. It's not coincidence. Don't let him watch the news.
Why won't you tell me what's going on? They were here.
Who?
The Whisper people.
The numbers are a warning. They're a warning to everyone.
This is not a test. This is an emergency broadcast transmission.
We're going to stay on the air for as long as possible.
Are we gonna die?
I will never let that happen, Caleb. Do you hear me? Never.
Okay, now let's go back to the order of events that happened to Jonathan. I was driving to go get Leche Kamala, and I was talking about the twin system and how they use the number 5, and obviously the letter is E, the letter E as a number 5, and they like the letter V, the Roman numeral 5, and that's their thing. That's their whole deal, because just like the 5 virgins. Think of a star right side up as an angel. It's got 5 points. An upside down star has got 5 points. It represents an angel that's been inverted. Now, the latitude and the longitude is 4275. 4275. I'm going to read it right here in this. I want you all to see this. Okay. I want you to think about just how profound this really is. Used of God, foreseen, planning out all history from eternity past. This guarantees all physical scenes of life operate according to, under his plan, and bringing equal eternal benefit to the person walking in faith, divine persuasion in each of them accordingly. 4275, proethon, and faith, 4102, pistis, are directly connected. Therefore, to be sure, those who are of faith are sons of Abraham. The scripture foreseen 4275 that God would justify the Gentiles by faith, 4102. Okay, and also this same exact word, the same word is used to say, and that God reveals nothing except he reveals it first to his prophets. So I'm going to tell you what's coming right now. The fire's coming. Watch. So after seeing this, naturally, I was a little bit, wow. Well, at the end of the movie, if you've watched the movie, you find out that poor Nicolas Cage, he has to let his children go, but he's not allowed to go with them because he didn't hear the call. You know what the Bible says in Revelation 3? Whoever has an ear, let him hear. The Bible also says to the angel of the church of Philadelphia, because you have kept the word of my patience and my command to persevere, I will keep you from the hour of temptation that shall come upon the whole earth to test them that dwell upon the earth. So he's being told he gets to go. He also finds out that those that are the synagogue of Satan, which I deal with every day, he says, I will make them come and kneel before thy feet to know that I have loved thee. Because, well, without getting into the whole internal aspect of what I know that means, or what I believe that means, God's letting them know, no, I love, this is my servant whom I love, who is willing to persevere for the faith, for the truth. And because of that, I'm going to keep him and those that are the church from the hour of testing, because they believed and they made themselves ready. Just like the kids in the movie, did you hear the call or not? Yes or no? I heard the call in 2002 and I reacted to it. And what did I do? Oh my gosh, Jesus is coming. Let me show you. This is what the Lord showed me here. You know what? Here. Oh my gosh. Look at what he showed me on the U.S. currency. He showed me that the Twin Towers is on there. Yeah, the Pentagon's on the backside. Oh my gosh. And I just started off to the races. Just, oh my gosh. And I started gathering information, supernatural information that was just being poured through me at a rate I almost couldn't deal with. It still overloads me. It's a gift of the Holy Spirit. So anyway, so then I saw 7137. Now, I don't want people weirding out when I show you 7137, because I prayed about this. I said, Lord, if I'm not accounted worthy to go, so be it. And I heard the Lord say, no, let me show you something. And he literally drove me to a door. He told me to drive somewhere. And I drove right to where he said, and I got out of my car, and I'll show you what he showed me. Corey was on the phone for that. I said, this is so weird. I hear the Lord telling me to take a right and go to the home store right now. I was like, this is so weird. I was like, I guess he set me up for something. But I had literally said, I pray that I'm accounted worthy. Bible says that the angel of the Church of Philadelphia gets to leave, but I never take anything for granted, to be honest. Okay, so here we go. So 71, what's the other number? What's the other? 7137. Strong 7137. Now this is because the dad did not get to leave. And so this guy that did the movie, he knew that. The spirit running him knew. Now look what 7137 means. It means it's from Deuteronomy. It's one occurrence. It's talking about someone that is not clean by reason of uncleanness that chanceth him by night. It is not clean emission of a nocturnal. So it's the definition is chance, accident. It really means chance or an accident. So the dad didn't get to leave in the movie, but that has nothing to do with us or those that have been called, I should say. Now, here's what the Lord led me to do. To look it up, broken down. I lead away, bring a person or animal, guide, spend a day, lead, bring, carry away. And then 7137, to make holy and to consecrate. Let me make sure I got that right. Yep, 7137. So first of all, I see beforehand because it was the rapture in the movie. The kids got to leave holding their bunny rabbits to lead away a person or animal to guide. I make holy, treat as holy, sanctify, hallow, purify, regard as special and holy and set apart. That's funny because when I came home from the thing in Grand Junction, the Lord took me to Eden, told me to get out of the car at the city limit, and he told me to look up the number of people on the population in the Bible in front of a witness, and it meant consecrated potter's clay, because everything I do on faith. If the Lord tells me to do it, I do it. I mean, you want me to jump out of a plane in Grand Junction? Okay, I'll do it. Just show me that's what you want me to do, and I'll act on faith. So, in the movie, to foresee beforehand, I see beforehand, to know it's coming, just like the movie Knowing. And here we go, to lead away, carry away, and to set apart as holy and sanctify. Okay, now, I know that this has taken a little while. I wanted to set it up because now I'm getting ready to freak you out. So I was like, what? Right there, I was like, okay, my brain's about to explode. Guys, from this point on, just watch the confirmations. Ready? Here we go. So I told you where it started, going to get led to Kamala, brevity, V between two E's, E and E. I come home, I turn on the movie Knowing, and then there's a letter, and the letter has the locations and of what's going to happen, and he goes to that location, and he goes to Lucinda's house, and he flips upside down the mattress. Isn't that just perfect? The mattress gets flipped upside down, and the E and the E stands for everyone else. Well, that matches exactly the E and the E on brevity. You know what the word brevity means? And the Lord told me to look it up. It means a very short space of time. So now the word brevity coffee is associated with the Lord telling me brevity. It's coming quickly, Jonathan. I'm like, wow. So the E and the E, like everyone else, it's going to die, is coming quickly. I was like, that's crazy. So now let's keep going in order. So then I see the coordinates. So this picture should have been right here. This picture should have been right here. And I see the coordinates. And then the coordinates, I've shown you what those mean. And then I'm sitting there, I'm like, that's crazy. So I decide I'm going to go back today and I'm going to get a clean shot of brevity coffee so you can really see that V is right between the E and the E, just like the movie Knowing, everyone else. And I just thought, I got to go get it. And when you put a V between there, it's Eve, E-V-E, Eve, which is how it all happened. So they're mocking Eve. And it's the spear tip, it's like representing the serpent having intercourse, the angel with Eve. Now watch this. At that point, I was thoroughly 100% convinced that, oh my God, the Lord's saying he's coming soon. I'd already seen the coordinates. I'd already seen the two E's, everyone else. And then there's one of my buddies over at the office, Big Rob. Big Rob calls me. I called Big Rob today because I went by the office and I was like, hey, what's going on? I didn't see anybody over there. And there's usually a lot of, there's stuff going on, like rebuilding engines and stuff like that. And I called him up just to see what was going on, and nobody was there. And he said, I'm down at EE Machine Shop. Hey, what are you doing, man? Where are you? And I hear I'm at EE Machine Shop while I'm sitting here looking at EE on everyone else and Brevity Coffee, EE. And I'm like, what? You're at EE Machine Shop? And I tell him on the phone, take a picture of me. Send me a picture. I used to have an office on South Flores. Take a picture. I want to see EE Machine Shop. You can see that. This is my phone. This is my cell phone. Look right behind him. EE Engine Machine Shop. Are you joking me? EE Machine Shop? I was like, that's insane. And so I document it. See right there? EE. So he took a picture with the E, and what's on it? Oh, a finish line tape, red and checkered tape. That's weird. That's starting to fit with everything else. Then I'm calling, I think, Cat or Corey. I can't remember at this point. And I'm sitting there at a traffic light on Broadway, and this big truck pulls up next to me. And I just, in my spirit, knew to look over. And I'm looking at a V with an E facing one way and an E facing another way. And I just went, what in the heck is going on? You're kidding me. EE here, EE here, EE on Brevity, EE on everyone else, and a latitude and longitude that says to know beforehand. Now, y'all ready to freak out? I was inside my house and I walked out the front door and I was on the phone with Corey going, I'm about to freak out. This is impossible. The movie Knowing with everyone else, and it's a movie about a fire that's coming to destroy everything. Right when I walked out my door, those kind of words were coming out of my mouth as part of the conversation. And when I walked out the door, let me show you what was parked in front of my house. I took a picture. I was like, oh my Lord, you see that truck? That truck was parked right outside my house. And it's a pretty big truck. I noticed it while I was talking about the movie Knowing. Let me show you the side of the truck. Let me just show you the side of the truck right here. And how the movie Knowing was about everything burning. There's the side of the truck that's parked in front of my house. Just try and absorb that. It's a house that's burning down at the very moment I'm walking out a door saying, this is mind-blowing. This is blowing my mind. Look at all these perfect confirmations. I mean, really Knowing and everything's burning. Everything's EE, Brevity Coffee, EE. Big Rob is at EE Engine Shop. A truck pulls up next to me with a V and an EE. Knowing EE. I mean, you got to be joking me. And I go, that's insane. And I walk out the door and that truck's parked in front of my house. I was like, this is about to go live. It's about to happen. And I hear in my spirit, yes, it's coming any moment. Oh, it gets better too, guys. So make sure you sit tight. So while this was going on, I was checking comments on my video that I put up early this morning. And someone said, look, I found a clip from the Predator movie where the Predator makes the noise like a locust. And so I watched this whole clip. And I was looking up, I was having Dave, I said, Dave, would you put the exact definition of brevity, you know, from brevity coffee with the two E's and the V in the middle. I was telling Dave, Dave, please put the V, or please put the definition of brevity in the show notes. And then I'm looking at comments and someone left this. Let me show you what's in this. Okay, so remember the locust sounds we were doing yesterday? So someone sent this. Watch this. And I was like, oh, wow, that's pretty crazy. And someone also posted a video of many years ago when my phone was taken over by that kind of a sound. And I felt kind of sick. And I heard the Lord say that was an alien communication. I'm like, that's crazy. Chris Hansen was at my house. And I told Chris, Chris, I heard the Lord say this was like an alien communication. What the hell does that mean? And I heard the Lord tell me way back then, go open that book. And I opened up a book and it said alien communication. Xeno. And I was just like, that's insane. So this video right here was in the comment section, but watch this. I didn't want to show it to you because of the noise. I wanted to show it to you for another reason. Dave was looking up the meaning of brevity, and I was checking this out at some point during that. Let me show you what happens in this thing. So during this clip, and I highly suggest you go watch the whole thing, listen to what gets said right here at the end. Now watch. You hear the words, you hear the word anytime, which happens to be the title of the video is called anytime. While you're looking up brevity? Are you kidding? I mean, who could orchestrate this kind of timing? You're looking up brevity and you're watching, you're having Dave look up brevity and you're watching this and it says anytime. And then the predator takes his hand like this, turns it upside down and opens up five. And look what it looks like is in it. Mind-boggling. Wow, that looks just like a scorpion, doesn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Anytime, because I know that the scorpions from the pit are coming any moment. They could come at any time now. I've already rung the bell. The building is from Adam to locust. The artwork is from Adam to locust. You starting to catch this? You see all these impossible, perfectly tied together, synchronistic, perfect pieces of data? This is not possible. Now watch. Anytime again. So he says anytime twice. Look right here at the, look at the title. Anytime. Imagine you're me and you're saying, okay, Dave, I need you to put the definition of brevity in there for everybody so everybody knows. And there it is. Brevity, it means a shortness of time or duration, briefness. Brevity, anytime, anytime. And I'm just, and I just hear the Lord telling me, Jonathan, tell everybody to be ready now. It can happen anytime. I'm warning you. I'm warning you now. I love you in Christ. I'm warning you. This is what happened in the last 24 hours. We're not even close to done yet. I'm not joking. Okay, so brevity, shortness in duration or time. Anytime. Now watch. Now watch how the hand turns upside down. It turns the opposite direction and opens up. And it looks like a scorpion. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Anytime.
Anytime.
That's insane. That's just not even possible. Okay, now let's go back. Now let me just keep going and show you what else happened, which is all impossible. I've been freaking out all day, guys. It's been insane. Okay, here we go. Now, let's see, brevity. And so we have all the EEs over and over. Let's look at one of these panels Dave made. Dave made a couple panels. Let's see. Oh, okay, wait a minute. When I was talking to Corey, at some point I was walking out the door, and Corey was watching a movie called Urban Justice. Okay, let me call Corey back. Let's call Corey back. Call Corey. Yo, hey, I got the recorder still going, so I thought I'd jump back in with you. Freak out.
Okay. Yep.
Okay, so during this whole crazy ongoing revelation, like one thing after another, does that sound about right?
That's totally correct.
Has it been like a freak out 24 hours?
It's just one thing after another, man. It's all supernatural from the Lord God, man.
It's unbelievable. So, yep. So we're watching, so we're talking about all this stuff and the V and the V and the end and the fire and the burning and the pit opening and locusts and all that stuff. And you decide to watch some movie last night, right?
Yeah, I started it last night, got super tired, and I'm like, oh, I'll just watch it. You know, I'll finish it tomorrow because I rented it from YouTube. So, you know, I get up in the morning and I start watching this movie. We'd already talked about some stuff that already happened. So
you're watching my video, but I'd already sent you the clip of Predator where it's making like the grasshopper, the locust noise, and then he opens his hand and he has like a scorpion on it. Yeah, okay, and then you text me or something. You got a hold of me, and then you were watching this movie called Urban Justice. Okay, now go ahead.
Well, before I did that, remember, well, I don't know if you want me to mention that part, but when you had said the five months from...
Oh, right. Yeah.
End of your video.
Yeah, at the end of the video yesterday, I didn't even realize that I had said it's 5 months till August, and that's how long the gestation period is for the men will seek death. Yeah. And so we were talking about the 5 months from the video yesterday, and I was just like, that's insane. I didn't even realize it, right? And then you tell me, well, guess what? I'm watching this movie. Go ahead.
And so I went back. I started watching the end of that the Steven Seagal movie. And in the movie, they're opening, there was a drug deal that went down in the movie, and the guy opens the case, and one of the guys says to the other dude, what do you got? And he opens up the case. There's a scorpion printed on the bag of the cocaine, the drugs. And he goes, what do you got? And he goes, I got 200 keys and about 3 million cash. And I'm like, you got to be kidding.
because we know very well 200 is?
Locust
from the pit. And 3 is?
Abaddon.
The angel of the bottomless pit. And while we've been looking at all this other data, that just happened to come up.
Yeah, finger and lip up and down quickly.
You know what? Let's do it together. Ready? Yeah. Yeah. All right, man. Thanks. I'll check you back in a bit. Bye.
Okay. Bye.
Uh-huh. So I'm telling you guys, there's more. There's more. There is more that has to do with 5 and 5. There's more that has to do with getting rid of the old man and bringing in the new man. I told you they're ushering in their new race right now. That's what this whole world shutdown is. I've been telling you. Okay, so there's Corey's little thing that happened. And that came on the heels of this. Anytime. We already know what the coordinates were. To see in advance, to foresee, and I've foreseen what's coming because the Lord God has shown it to me. Surely the Lord does nothing yet until he reveals it to his servants, the prophets. Sorry, for my stuttering there. And then here all these other crazy confirmations are. But let me show you something very, very, very odd. The time capsule that they pull out of the ground in the Lucinda movie, let's see if it's here. In the Knowing movie, in the movie Knowing, there's the time capsule. Look at what the time capsule comes out of. Oh, wow, it's the Star of Lucifer. See it right here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And look at it. The rays are half black, half white. That's the Star of Lucifer, guys. And they pull out the time capsule, and there's a date on it right here. And I've taken that date, and I've got it here in the show notes. Let's see, and I've got it right here. 1959, it means to take care of, and what's the movie about? He's trying to take care of the kids and get the kids to safety, and the whole thing is about trying to get people to safety, to take care of them, and get them out before the fire comes. And then the other number on that thing is 2009, right? Let's see, 2009 right there. So 2009. Okay, so watch this. 2009 punishment. Because guess what the punishment that's coming for the world is? Fire. Water came one time. Noah told everybody it was coming. Fire's coming. I'm telling you, I'm the guy. I know that's hard to believe. It's hard for me to believe. But everything that I've done proves it. The little building outside with the crown on it and all the video that did happen with the crown and the meaning of everything that the Lord had me paint it with the color red. That means he has arisen. It shall be a sign unto them. You couldn't think any of this up. You couldn't even imagine it. But yet it's all happening, isn't it? And so there it is. So now watch this. So even the time capsule means to take care of and then punishment. Because there's those that are going to get to go and that'll be taken care of. And then there's those that will be punished because they didn't accept the free gift of God. Now, here is a picture of a guy and a girl that are like embraced two different energies. And the female energy is taking over the male energy. That's what this all is. It's all about female energy encompassing male energy and burning up the male energy. Kind of like the party they have in the desert called the Burning Man Party, which I've shown you and I've done videos of, where they make an effigy of a man and they burn it. And it's all about feminine energy. Burning Man. The coordinates of the Burning Man Festival are literally 119. 119 is the number of man in the Bible, meaning red, ruddy. You can't even think this stuff up. No one could think it up. And the other coordinate for it is Amalekite, an Amalekite king. You know, like a heathen king. Burning Man. Heathen king, Burning Man. And so you couldn't think this stuff up. You couldn't even imagine this stuff. But let's go to the Google Doodle for today. Wow. There it is. There's the paradigm. There's five fingers there and there's five there. You wouldn't think this is really anything, would you? Let's watch it. Eight. You see all the eight pointed little stars of Lucifer? What you're going to see is you're going to see some isotoxal stars, which are four pointed stars, which I did a whole series on in the twin thing. Isotoxal means edge transitive. That means basically you're becoming your evil twin when the whole system rotates. When the system rotates, you become your reflection. It's basically becoming your own reflection. That's what isotoxal is. It's called edge transitive. And in this little hand washing thing that you think you're looking at, there's a guy with a timer button here. Look, you see the little timer? Watch. And while it's counting off the seconds right here, if you're paying attention and you're watching the little bursting stars of Lucifer, right there, there you go. Did you see them right there? Watch. Each one's an 8-pointed star. And it's showing the cycle going around the cycle, and then you're going to see edge transitive. One's right side up, one's upside down. See it? And this is like a sexual thing right here they're doing. And look, it's straight up and down. See right here? And then they're going to count down the clock because they know time's up. And you see the old man right here? This is the old system. Let me go to the album before we get there. Let me show you what they're really doing. The old system, let me show you what they're doing. You remember that picture I showed you where it's new man? All you got to do is turn this upside down. It's the same thing. New man. Either way you flip it, it's the same. Well, did you know when you take this guy and you watch this video closely and you see these stars of Lucifer popping, clapping, one becomes the other. It switches sides. It's edge transitive, and it does it right after an isotoxal star. But let me show you this. This is what's most telling. The old man becomes the new man. And I'll just leave it framed up right there. You see the new man right here? Eye, mouth, hair. It's almost like a man slash woman. Which one is it? Is it a man or is it a woman? Well, isn't the whole system all about this androgynous thing? There it is. There's the new man right there. You see it? The new man has been created. And what have they done? They're washing their hands of the old man. Coronavirus. Told you. They're crowning their kingdom. The one hand is washing out the other one, and they want two left hands. Basically, that's as metaphorically speaking. They want two of the upside down fives. They don't want five and five. They want five and five. They don't want this anymore. They want this. Fully down. And those of us that leave, we're fully up. And we leave. Wow. It's a Google Doodle. Watch. Watch the isotoxal stars. You couldn't even think this up. Look at the countdown. Watch. Oh, there it is. Look, the one became the other. See the isotoxal stars? The one became the other. We washed them right out of the system, guys. And now, oh, there, boom. And now everything is two hands that belong to Lucifer. And there you go. There's an eight-pointed star, eight-pointed star, eight-pointed star. I hate to say I told you so. Not really, I told you so. This is supernatural knowledge. This is supernatural ability to see into their world. Their time is here. They have taken over the host body system. The pit's about to open. The fire is about to come. All hell's about to break loose. And if you're not in Christ, God have mercy on you. You will see the greatest horror the world's ever seen. I'm just being straightforward. So, I hate to be the bearer of bad news. It's good news, though, to those of us that have been converted. Those of us that are Christians, you know, I mean, we have a lot to be excited about. We have the hopeful expectation that we'll be taken out before all the horror begins. The Bible says, pray that you're counted worthy to escape, A, some of the horrors, B, a lot of the horrors, C, most of the horrors, or D, all of the horrors that are coming on this world. D, all of these horrors. that shall come to pass. So we are so close to those horrors coming to pass that it's got to be very soon, because don't forget, they'll be eating, drinking, marrying, and giving in marriage, just like the days of Noah, right up until the time they went into the ark, and then the flood came and took them all away. It'll be the same at the end of the world. So that's going away pretty quickly, isn't it? I mean, life as usual is, I hate to say it, but when I rang that bell the other day on my birthday, did you notice how quickly things started to change from that day? And I'm not, I didn't even want to kind of mention it, but from the day I rang that bell, I saw such a super fast progression of things, all things getting weird, everything shutting down, states closing everything, shutting down the whole state. I was like, what? That's crazy. Corona, Saint Corona. They put her upside down. They pulled down two palm trees and whoosh, split the V in half. Told you. So anyway, so let me go back and look at the folder, because my mind is so blown. I know I don't want to forget a whole bunch of stuff. Oh yeah, my goodness. Let's take a look at this guy right here. Who is this guy? Let's see who he is. His name is Ignaz Semmelweis. And let's see, Kat. I got Kat to thank for this. Kat went and looked up Mr. Ignaz Semmelweis. So can you imagine every single thing I've shown you, all the numbers are totally significant. I'm sorry, significant, just like the movie Knowing, that there's a key to understanding all this. There's a pattern.
Okay, why are you showing me this? It's a list of dates. Every major global disaster for the last 50 years in perfect sequence. From a piece of paper that's been buried in the ground.
And now Jonathan Kleck is seeing EE. Not once, not twice, not three times, not four, five times. EE. Big Rob's at EE Machine Shop. Brevity Coffee with a V through the EE. I watch Knowing, EE, everything else. A big truck pulls up next to me with a V with an EE. I walk out the door, there's a truck parked in front of my house with a building burning on it. I turn on Predator and it says, anytime. And he turns his hand over and he opens it up, there's a scorpion. Corey's watching some movie and they're selling kilos of coke. They have 200, which means locust, and 3 million, which is the angel of the bottomless pit. What? That's like, quick, call Miley Cyrus and tell her to get her bear trap ready. I mean, this is off the hook. This is off the hook. So, let's go back to the album. Let me show you something. Okay, let me show you something. Mr. Ignaz, here we go. Let's take a look at when he was born in 1818. So that's why they use this. Watch, because our enemy hates us. He was born in 1818, and he was called the Savior of Mothers. Look at that. He was known as the Savior of Mothers, and he was born in 1818. Well, let's look up Strong's 1818. Oh, remember they said in the movie, Knowing, that he said tomorrow 81 people are going to die. Oh, the Brotherhood of Christ. See? Remember they said 81? The Brotherhood of Christians. The Christian Church. They're talking about slaughtering us all. Okay, let me go back to this. Sorry. Let's go back to, we'll do it Strong's 1818 right here. Watch it. We'll just do it live. To seduce fully. 1818. To seduce whole and seduce wholly and deceive completely. Wholly. Properly, thoroughly deceived, hoodwinked. Emphasizes the end impact of deception. And this is on the guy washing his hands with the isotoxal stars and the stars of Lucifer, where they switch sides and the they washed the old man out and brought the new man in. Right side up, upside down. I told you. I told you. That's what I've been saying. And it's here. Look. Deceived into illusion emphasizes the end impact of deception, missing true reality because biting on the bait that brings the hook. That's what it means. That's the guy that's this guy. That's what his birthday is. And when you turn this guy upside down, I want you to look at his eyes right now. It's a U and a U. It's a W, and his eyes are closed. But when you turn him upside down, the eyes are open, and it looks kind of like a man-woman. Look, see it? Is it a boy or is it a girl? But the eyes are open. They're bringing in the new man. They've washed out the old man, and they brought in the new man. Wow. Just like that picture I showed you. New man. So now let's look at the other word. 1847 is when he came up with the little, he worked for the World Health Organization, the WHO. Well, do you know who's running this whole coronavirus? Shut everything down, get everybody locked up so we know where to get everybody. You know who's doing it? The WHO. Get it? The WHO. Just like the man. Okay. In 1847, look what it means, to despise. You know what? Let's just do the expanded version. Let's do right here. 1847. See, I know how to read their language, just like the movie Knowing. There is a pattern. There is a way to know. To despise. To despise and to treat with contempt. To bring to nothing. Look. Completely out of, which intensifies this word, bring to nothing. The word bring completely to naught. See, look, bring completely to naught. Scorned, despised, rejected, ill-treated with contempt. Right there. Now let's watch that Google Doodle. That's us, guys. Our eyes were closed. There's a W. And our enemy is washing us out of the system, bringing us to complete end and ruin. That's what the Google Doodle is. And they're doing it amid the coronavirus. Pay attention to the countdown right here and the number right here. Because when it started at 12. Up here is 12 o'clock. But when it goes all the way around, look at what the number right here is. Pay attention. And where did it end? It ended at, see the Star of Lucifer? It ends at 6. Watch, 6 right there. So 12, 6 should be down here. So it starts at 12 and it ends at 6. Turned us upside down, told you. And to fully and completely destroyed us. And there's your isotoxal stars. Etched one hand becomes the other. Told you. Are you telling me all this is possible in one day? Okay, whatever. Guys, the end of the world is here. Praise God, man. Thank God. I'm so ready to get out of here. Oh, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Group hug. Y'all ready? I love you in Christ. I love you guys. Wow. Y'all should go through those show notes yourself. Y'all should go through all of that yourself. Watch the videos yourselves. I mean, just go through this stuff. You couldn't think this stuff up. I mean, you couldn't even think it up. The only way you could do this is to know the understanding everything's upside down. That's the only way to do it. There's no other way. There's a pattern. There's a system. And I understand that system. The Lord taught it to me the night I got saved. And he's been teaching me ever since. I was led by the Spirit of the Most High. The end of the world's here. All glory to God. Put all your trust in Jesus. He's the way, the truth, and the life. He's the King of Kings, and he's the Lord of Lords. And he runs everything. So trust in him. All right, guys. God bless you. I love you guys. Peace and grace.